It is well known that if you can locate lung cancers early, when they're small, when they have not spread, then there's a much greater chance of cure, and that's where the low-dose screening program comes in.
The idea would be to pick up spots in the lung at an earlier stage, leading to an earlier diagnosis and possible cure.
In general, in the United States, we've needed a good screening examination to try to detect lung cancer at an early stage. Certainly here in Jacksonville, more than, you know, just about any other place in the nation. So now we actually have one. We can deliver very high quality imaging and diagnosis with minimal radiation dose with the low dose CAT scan.
We're looking for patients who are most likely to develop lung cancer. In general, patients who have had a smoking history or are currently smoking are at higher risk for lung cancer, or if they have a family history of cancer, especially lung cancer, those are patients that are more likely to be detected by a screening program and also have improved outcome if they do have a cancer.
As a pulmonologist, we've been waiting decades to come up with a screening tool. There's nothing more frustrating than diagnosing cancer in an advanced stage when you know something could have been done earlier, which may have been potentially curative for that patient. The first step would be to see as a primary physician or a primary care doctor to look at your patient population and see if they fall into the high-risk group, which is ages 55 to 74, with a smoking history of about a pack a day for 30 years, active or former smokers, and offer them screening. The patient will be scheduled to get a CT scan, and preferably the same day after the CT scan is done, will be evaluated by a physician, whether it's a pulmonologist or a thoracic surgeon, to talk to them about the findings of the CT scans and give them a plan what we're going to do next. One of the guidelines actually strongly recommends that the lung cancer screening be implemented in institutes that have multidisciplinary teams, which typically include a pulmonologist, an oncologist, a thoracic surgeon, radiation oncologist, and a radiologist. The reason being, you have to understand what to do if you see something on a CT scan.
In detecting a small spot on the lung, something that may look a little abnormal, and from there then delivering that information to a physician who is specializing in pulmonary medicine and in the diseases of the lungs, and allow them to direct the patient's care from there.
We have new surgical techniques which allow us to do the procedure minimally invasively, so there is less pain for the patient, a shorter recovery time, and quicker return to normal activities. In fact, they go back to work within a few weeks. So that's a really big plus. So I'm very excited about this whole program.
Absolutely. There is no symptom that can point towards maybe you have cancer. Most of the cancers that are detected are incidentally when an imaging study is done for some other reason. Typically, most of the early cancers are completely asymptomatic. So the best advice would be if you fall into this risk category, if you're aged between 55 and 75, and you have smoked for at least a pack a day for 30 years, you should consider doing a CT scan, a low-dose CT scan for lung cancer screening.
I think it's great, yeah. Certainly, again, anything we can do to catch cancer at an earlier stage and try to improve somebody's survival is going to be of utmost importance, and so I think that introducing this to Jacksonville and to Northeast Florida only has an upside. There is no downside.
So in a desire to improve the treatment of lung cancer, now we know that there is evidence that early detection through screening programs can save lives. I would say do it. It's your life.